Well, people with a grudge are turning more and more to the internet to express themselves, sometimes to the point of bullying and threats. The book, Viral Hate, Containing Its Spread on the Internet, takes a close look at this growing problem and proposes ways to resolve it. Now, Christopher Wolfe is the book's co-author. He joins us now live from New York. Thanks for joining us. I mean, the internet's been around for a long time, and who is responsible primarily for policing the internet? The publications in which, or the chat rooms, or the very search engines they're on?
Well, there really isn't a policeman for the internet, and the issue of online hate has grown to an epidemic proportion. That's why we call it a viral problem. And we think the entire internet community has an obligation to police this epidemic of hate, because it has really terrible, pernicious effects, not just only on the people looking at the internet, it's kind of a pollution on the internet, but it affects the people who it's targeting. Including kids and minorities. And we've seen how it leads to real-world violence, and that's where viral hate takes its most hideous form.
And even in the comments sections of certain publications, some of the comments are just so insidious. I think it was George Clooney who once said that he did once Google himself only to discover that the comments were so hideous that he decided that the people who were writing them were just lonely, sad people in dark basements. Who can stop these kind of comments? Because within a publication, for example, presumably there's a moderator, or there could be a moderator, and there surely are legal aspects for some of the things people are saying or not saying.
So the volume of speech on the internet is enormous, and I want to make it very clear that my co-author, Abe Foxman, who's the national director of the Anti-Defamation League, and I chair the National Civil Rights Committee, believe very strongly in the First Amendment and in free expression. But we recognize that there are something like 500 new websites every minute, 300,000 tweets, tens of thousands of Facebook postings, and 600 hours of video on YouTube every single minute. Hmm. And included in there, and included in the comment sections to newspapers that you mentioned, are some pretty hideous things that are being said. There's something about the separation that the computer provides, that people alone in their room or looking at their device say things that they would never say face to face.
The mask of anonymity. They can hide.
Exactly. The mask of anonymity plays a role here too. So one thing is very clear. We don't think the law is an appropriate or an effective tool. It's a little bit like cockroaches in the kitchen. You might get a few that are out and visible on the counter, but you're not going to get the many behind the wall. So we think it's a combined effort of getting the internet community involved. The sites that curate content like Facebook and YouTube can have terms of service and enforce those terms of service. We saw recently how women's group went to Facebook and insisted that misogynistic content that made light of the fact that women were being raped and in fact encouraged attacks on women. These women's group protested Facebook and to the advertisers on Facebook, and Facebook promised to do a better job. They actually have been a very positive player in this fight against online hate. So we think the intermediaries have a role to play, but individuals do too. You know, when you see something, say something is not something that should be restricted to backpacks in airports and train stations. People should speak up against online hate and not just accept it as a given.
Are you confident that the industry can regulate itself?
I am, and I think that that's the way it ought to be. Free expression really demands that the government stay out of this. And we've seen in places where the government does intervene, we do see that where the government has intervened, it makes martyrs out of the people that they prosecute, and it actually serves to syndicate or have their stuff republished. And so the law is really not an effective tool at all.
All right, we'll have to leave it there. Christopher Wolfe, thank you very much, co-author of the book, Viral Hate, Containing Its Spread on the Internet. Thank you very much indeed for joining us.